Travels with a Donkey in the Cévennes by Robert Louis Stevenson. In a little place called Les Monastiers, in a pleasant highland valley 15 miles from Le Puy, I spent about a month of fine days. Monastiers is notable for the making of lace, for drunkenness, for freedom of language, and for unparalleled political dissension. In the midst of this Babylon, I found myself a rallying point. Everyone was anxious to be kind and helpful to the stranger. This was not merely from the natural hospitality of mountain people, nor even from the surprise with which I was regarded as a man living of his own free will in Le Monastier, when he might just as well have lived anywhere else in this big world. It arose a good deal from my projected excursion southward through the Cévennes. A traveller of my sort was a thing hitherto unheard of in that district. I was looked upon with contempt, like a man who should project a journey to the moon, but yet with a respectful interest, like one setting forth for the inclement pole. All were ready to help in my preparations. A crowd of sympathizers supported me at the critical moment of a bargain. Not a step was taken but was heralded by glasses round and celebrated by a dinner or a breakfast. It was already hard upon October before I was ready to set forth, and at the high altitudes over which my road lay, there was no Indian summer to be looked for. I was determined, if not to camp out, at least to have the means of camping out in my possession. A tent, above all for a solitary traveller, is troublesome to pitch, and troublesome to strike again, and even on the march it forms a conspicuous feature in your baggage. A sleeping sack, on the other hand, is always ready. You have only to get into it. It serves a double purpose: a bed by night, a portmanteau by day, and it does not advertise your intention of camping out to every curious passerby. After repeated visits to Le Puy, and a deal of high living for myself and my advisers, a sleeping sack was designed, constructed, and triumphantly brought home. This child of my invention was nearly 6 feet square, exclusive of two triangular flaps to serve as a pillow by night, and as the top and bottom of the sack by day. I call it the sack, but it was never a sack by more than courtesy. Only a sort of long roll or sausage, green waterproof cart cloth without, and blue sheep's fur within. It was commodious as a valise, warm and dry for a bed, and in case of heavy rain I proposed to make myself a little tent, or tentlet, with my waterproof coat, 3 stones, and a bent branch. It will be readily conceived that I could not carry this huge package on my own merely human shoulders. It remained to choose a beast of burden. What I required was something cheap and small and hardy, and of a stolid and peaceful temper, and all these requisites pointed to a donkey. There dwelt an old man in Monastier, of rather unsound intellect according to some, and known to fame as Father Adam. Father Adam had a cart, and to draw the cart, a diminutive she-ass, not much bigger than a dog, the colour of a mouse, with a kindly eye and a determined underjaw. There was something neat and high-bred, a Quakerish elegance about the rogue that hit my fancy on the spot. Her first interview was in Monastier Marketplace. To prove a good temper, one child after another was set upon her back to ride, and one after the other went head over heels into the air, until a want of confidence began to reign in youthful bosoms, and the experiment was discontinued from a dearth of subjects. I was already backed by a deputation of my friends, but as if this were not enough, all the buyers and sellers came round and helped me in the bargain, and the ass and I and Father Adam were the centre of a hubbub for near half an hour. At length, she passed into my service for the consideration of 65 francs and a glass of brandy. The sack had already cost 80 francs and 2 glasses of beer, so that Modestine, as I instantly baptized her, was upon all accounts the cheaper article. Indeed, that was as it should be, for she was only an appurtenance of my mattress, or a self-acting bedstead on four casters. By the advice of a fallacious local saddler, a leather pad was made for me with rings to fasten on my bundle, and I thoughtfully completed my kit and arranged my toilet. By way of armory and utensils, I took a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.